Oh, Lord. Couldn't get to sleep for the longest time last night. Didn't help my brain when shut up. Well, here goes another day.
Come on, Raven. You need to get up. You've got stuff you need to do today. But no energy.
Meh. Alright, let's try taking a rest for just a little bit.
I wonder if Emerald's going to do well with the trainer. I know we've had our homework and we've been working really hard on it. But what if he doesn't do well? And then what if we get there and he sees big dogs? And he freaks out, slips out of his leash, and takes off running away from me, ends up getting hit by a car and killed. Then I won't have a service dog. That's not good.
Well, these guys have finally got me up. Let's face it, most of the time they're the reason I get up. You can go outside. Outside! Now if I can get them out the door. But they don't listen to me. Why would they?
Why are you eating these? You've already had a few this morning. Do you really want to be that fat again? You're fat enough as is. You're fat and disgusting. Why do you even eat anymore?
And now back to just laying around and doing nothing. Because Lord knows, there could be all sorts of other things I could do, but apparently, going outside wore me out way too much. Why do I feel so blech? Like, my mood is meh, and my body just feels so tired. Could this be hypothyroidism? No, it probably isn't. Nobody believes that you would have it anyway. You're already deemed kind of crazy, so... doubt a type of thyroidism. Maybe you're just lazy. You're just lazy and good for nothing and can't do anything, can you? Except lay in bed, watch YouTube, and then eventually go to work and be a horrible salesman. So, yay, goody.
There goes that nap. Now to make myself look less like a hot mess for work. Hi!
Alright. Go outside. Now to make myself look less disgusting for work. But let's face it, you're gonna look like a hot mess anyway.
Alright, so before all that, let's, just take a little look-see, make sure that my face is all nice and clean. Dang it, that just killed like 20 minutes of my time. I'm gonna be running late for work, aren't I?
I love these puppers. Just gonna say that.
I love you.
What a good boy. What a good boy. What a good girl. Oops, I about stabbed your eye. I'm sorry.
Alright, now you've gone from a hot mess to a professional looking hot mess. Good job, Raven. Really good job.
Oh, goody. Now I'm 15 minutes late. Normally this would bother me, but at this point I'm just too drained to care. But at least maybe I can stay an extra 15 minutes to make up for it and make my 4 hours. All right, good job, Raven. Work actually went very well today. You didn't make your minimum, but I mean, let's face it, the minimum is kind of hard for the town you live in. So we're going to go and get Panda Express. But you know what's kind of awkward? The fact that you go to Panda a lot, now you recognize two people, and now they're gonna think that you're just some fatty because you come to Panda all the freaking time. And that's just gonna be really awkward. Are you sure you wanna go inside? But I'm hungry now. But I don't wanna go in because I don't wanna feel awkward, but I'm hungry now and I really don't wanna wait to get home to eat it, so. Dilemmas. This looks so delicious. But it makes you look like a total fatty. So look, all you got is chicken and noodles. Now everybody thinks you're fat. And you're also annoying to the person that took your order because you've seen her before, so now she thinks you're annoying. And people also think you're weird because you are vlogging to yourself. So, yeah, enjoy your meal, fatty, and be ashamed of all the embarrassment you have caused yourself. I'll show you guys something that I've never shown in a vlog, and let's be honest, I'm a little bit nervous about it, but here we go. It's something I'm kind of obsessed with. I don't do it often, but I am obsessed with diet pills. And I know they're so unhealthy for you. I've tried a lot of these, not at the same time, to try and, because you guys know that I have huge insecurities about my weight. So here we are, back in this land again, dealing with this again. Yeah.
And now it's better lighting to pick even more at my face and abuse the living crap out of my skin. Featuring my dog.
Heard a noise. Probably nothing, probably heading to the door. But what if it was somebody breaking into our house? And then I would have to defend the house. And then they would hurt me.
And you would have to get out of the toilet because you're gross.
And they hurt me really bad. And they hurt Ritter really bad. And I would have to get my brother, when he comes home, to call 911 or something. You know that's not gonna happen. But what if?
I'm tired. But I got my baby boys and my beautiful girl. They're chewing on their horns. And feeling pretty all right now. We'll see what the night has for us.
Look, I already have insomnia brain. And I know that hygiene and taking care of your toes and your toenails is great. But doing it at freaking like midnight? Not the best idea. What better thing to do? Why should I sleep? Sleeping is for the weak. I don't like have a job at 9:30 in the morning tomorrow. Man, I don't have anything to do tomorrow. No, not at all. I have all the time in the world to just stay awake and not be able to sleep.
Well, hello, anxiety. Right when I'm trying to go to sleep, you decide to kick up for no apparent reason. What is it now? It's probably nothing. And now you've got chest tightening, heart racing, can't breathe, mind is going a billion miles an hour, and I can't sleep. What a way to end the day and end the insomnia than with a bunch of anxiety to keep you up for a little bit longer. Screw you, anxiety.